Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm uploading about LangChain use cases. I will speak about creating and use tools, a key component on LangChain, and a component will give us the opportunity to interact with any tool that you may imagine. In real time, interactively, at the time that you are working with an LLM. As in other occasions, I will upload this notebook to the repository, and you will be able to go through them in your local environment. And I put you as well some of the links relevant, and also we will look at a little bit or introduce what is LangChain Hub and Pandas, which is a tool, the manipulation tool, an analytics tool that we use in Python. And okay, let's go. What is a tool? A tool essentially is build an interface in human language to work together with an LLM in LangChain to interact and to with an external tool, with an external application, API, dataset, Python script, an arbitrary program, an arbitrary application, whatever. It's a way to to introduce information as well into the prompt, and they introduce information to provide context to the more context to the LLM in order to be the correct answer, and also a way to interactively create and execute again arbitrary commands or arbitrary queries or whatever you need to do using external tools. Everything is going to be part of the LangChain execution, either an agent or a chain. We will cover both scenarios. One is better than the other, under my opinion. And again, a very powerful tool, and it's something that you really need to know how it works when you are working with this library. Again, there is two ways again to work with or to create a tool and provide these tools, which is essentially providing abilities, in few words, no, or some features additionally to the LLM to do whatever you can imagine, in few words, because for example, you can an LLM, as you may know, doesn't know how to do a multiplication, or how to add two numbers, or how to do exponentiation, or how to calculate a derivative, or a limit, or an exponential, whatever. It doesn't know as well how to execute code. So this allow, or sea, this give the ability to the LLM to execute commands, to execute applications, to in real time invoke a query to an API, whatever, Google, DuckDuckGo, whatever you can imagine, make a query, send an email, remove a file from a file system, whatever you can imagine. We will look at later on, even you can execute an arbitrary, for example, command to in Python, and use the output of this command to be part of the context that will build the final answer that the LLM will return back to the user. And then you can use it either with chains or with agents. I personally prefer use agents because it's more flexible and it will make your life easier, but you can use it with both components in LangChain. If you create a chain, you need to be kind of aware, first of all, if you use only one tool. You can use one or multiple tools in the when you are interacting with your LLM in your process, in your information pipeline. You can interact with one or multiple tools. And then on the way that is done in change, this is done sequentially. So there is a predefined sequence of the tool usage, and this is key understanding that, because you finally are going to send an input, as you see here on the image, to the LLM. It will parse this input that is natural language, and it will assign or it will infer language change from this natural language which tools to use. And then the language change will use this tool, meaning that it will execute some command, a query, a list of files, whatever, and the output of the execution of that query, of that program or tool, it will return back to the LLM to build the final answer. So understanding that this is a sequential process, this means that also the command, the input that you provide to the LLM has to be kind of organized sequentially. And then this is somehow complicating a little bit your life. You will see later on in the demonstration I will make that this is slightly more complicated. Possible, but more complex than doing it with agents. And again, if you just are going to use a tool, for example, a Google search, or interacting with YouTube, or interacting with a database, or whatever. And then it doesn't really matter which one you use, because there is no problem in how the LLM is going to map when it considers necessary, not the LLM, LangChain, when it's going to use the tool, or when it's going to use the tool, because there is no other choice. It is appropriate to use the tool, you use it. It's not, there is no other chance to choose among a set of the tools. If there is only one, doesn't matter change of ages. If there is multiple, think that when you are working with a change, it's a sequential process, and when you're working with agents, it's an iteration process. No? And then what happened here, you send an input and user question, the LLM together with the parser analyze the natural language. You will see this later in a real example. And then on analyzing the natural language that you provide as input, it will choose the appropriate tool and execute or use that tool, meaning that it will make a search, make a calculation, execute a command. You will receive an observation. This observation will pass back to the LLM, and LLM together with LangChain will decide it is necessary to use another tool or not. It is necessary, will go again back, it will choose among those that among those that are linked to this agent, or that the agent had a connection with, and it will use it, create another observation, and going back again to the LLM. This is going in terms of the agent scrap path. This is like all the execution and intermediary steps are passing back to the LLM, and then on and LangChain, and they understand when it's necessary to go again into the loop and execute and run a tool or not. I had enough, I use everything is impossible to use because I'm connected to those tools. And once this loop finish, the LLM will build the final answer and return these answers to the user. We will look now at a real example, and you will understand easily how this is working. Again, the main takeout from here is change works sequentially, and also if you want to use multiple tools, you have to build your input in such way that if you have multiple tools, you have to indicate very precisely with commands in natural language, obviously. You will see later on, as well in the demonstration, which tools to use to provide the desired effect. And in agents, it's slightly different. It's an iterative process where the where line says understand together with LLM the question and use iteratively a tool among those that are connected to the chain to execute a command, provide an observation, and input this observation back to the chain execution. This is kind of reinforcement learning, if you want to say that, no? Or returning, introducing the output back in the loop and continue up to there is an escape when land change together with the LLM decide that is enough, or I cannot use in some cases more tools because I don't have available. In that case, I return the output to the user with the information I was able to obtain for among using the tools I had available in my chain. Okay, let's go. We install the as usual the libraries we need. We get we mount the drive, we get the key of OpenAI, and here we are creating custom tools. There is two types of tools, tools that we can import directly from LangChain, mostly LangChain community. There is also available sort of in LangChain experimental, and in LangChain core you have essentially the main classes, how to create tools, custom tools as we are doing here. But later on at the end of the notebook you had some examples of how to use these tools that are integrated with LangChain. I give you some links in the notebook. You had in community you had a vast amount of tools that you can use. I even didn't count them. There is a lot to interact, for example, with Bing, to interact with some of the Cognizant suites. Some of them I even know that they exist. DuckDuckGo, Search, Office 365, file management, operating systems, so moving files, sending emails, GIT, Gmail. Well, all this is just imported, instantiate the class, and use it. That's it. You don't need to do anything. These tools, you will see now how it works, and you will see how power is this this component in LangChain. There is a vast amount of tools that you just take a look just to understand how many you had available. Just is it. Ready to go. Here what we are doing is just importing tool from LangChain, and then you define a method here in Python, and you when you decorate this method with add tool, you are converting automatically this in a tool that LangChain can use to produce an intermediary output that later on the LLM will use to build the final answer. Here we are building three tools. One is multiply, add, and the other one is exponentiate. We create a list of tools, and then on we import. Here, first of all, we are going to look at what is hub. Hub LangChain hub is essentially something similar to what we had in Hugging Face. It's a place where you can find different prompts. Templates that you can use for different use cases. This is something that the community, also LangChain people, LangChain creators are developing and uploading here for use of the community. You can own yourselves as well and provide to the community as well. They are, as I said, prompts. We will see one this person wrote and uploaded here to the hub, and you can download this for free. Again, this is kind of the Like Hugging Face, if you are working with Transformers, you can connect to Hugging Face, you just pass the token and you can download any model available there or a data set. You can upload or fine tune your own models, push them there. This is something similar. But instead to be models there, we have prompts to use where in with LangChain. And then on here we take this one, is a prompt to work with the OpenAI, and it's quite simple. It's a prompt which contains a system message. It's very simple. You can create one. It's very, you just import the classes from LangChain and you build something like that, and you can push the prompt with your user to, obviously you have to register in the hub in order to push one, and you can build your own ones. And then you see here you place the placeholder for the chat history if you want to use it. Human message, this is the input that we're gonna send to the LangChain, and I in scrap patch. I explained already that in other videos, but this is all the intermediary steps that are happening when the chain is being executed are returning back to the chain in order to get or provide context about the execution or the intermediary steps that that LangChain is getting when executing the tools, and those intermediary steps and logs are passing back to the chain in order to use it and also to provide context to the LLM to build the final answer. And then the easiest way, as again in my opinion, is create an agent. You just import the create open to, in this case, as we are using OpenAI tool agent, and the agent executor. This class is common for any agent that you may want to create. We create the LLM, the model, and then we use the function to create the agent, LLM, the tools available for this LLM, and the prompt to use. And then once we had the agent created, we create an object agent executor. We pass the agent, we pass the tools hardware, and verbose true is just to see the intermediary steps, what's happening inside the chain, no? And you will see here. So we send this input, and you can see here we want the model to do some mathematical calculations, no? You know the same than me that the LLM is unable to do this. But how it's gonna do? We will use a LangChain to get these intermediary outputs using these functions that we define here, these tools, and then the intermediary outputs will return to the information loop. And then on, it will be used first of all by LangChain to create the final output, and at the end, the LLM to build you the final answer and the answer that the LLM or the LangChain return to the user. And you see here let's take an analysis of the sentence. No, take 7 to the 5th power and multiply that by the sum of 12 and 3. Then square the whole result. Think how is built this sentence. The sentence is not sequential. Why? Because to do this calculation, you had to first of all take 7 to the 5th power, then on sum 12 and 3, and then on multiply the output of this by the sum of this. And then on the output, you square the output. Okay, so it's not a sequential order, and this is made on purpose. Why? You will see now. What is doing the chain? Let's see. First of all, identify is understanding the natural language that we are using, and say, okay, take 7 to the 5th power, and then is mapping this sentence to the thanks to the tool exponentiate, and then it understanding the chain understand that the base is the number 7 and the exponent is number 5. And then what is doing now the LAN chain is executing this function, executing exponentiate, take the base and the exponent and execute the exponentiation. And this is executing in real time. And then you get the number. Secondly, as is understanding the sequence or the input globally, it understands that the next thing I need to do is sum 12 and 3. And it's exactly what it's doing. Add 12 and 3. Then on, it knows that I need to multiply the intermediary outcomes of these two functions. And it's exactly what it's doing. Multiply this by 15, which is the add of 12 plus 3. And at the end, square the whole result. And then exponentiate again, base 2, 2. So the number, which is the sum of this to the 2. And this is the final output. And then on this final output, together with the intermediate steps, are passed through to the LLM for to build the final answer. And you have it here. Again, you see here the power, you can understand the power that had this. No? Here we are using some arbitrary tools again can be, as you will see later on the bottom, can be querying a database, manipulating a file in a file system, whatever you can do with the tools that you had available, or with tools that you can build yourself, custom tools as we are doing here. Now let's see how to do the same, slightly the same, because you will see what is the problem to do this with chains. Again, with chains, executing a single tool is fine, no problem. But executing something complex as we did now, in this, where you need to have a holistic view of the whole input and understanding which tools execute and in which order, this is much more complicated to do it with chains than with agents. And then to do something similar, we need to use the JSON output tool parser and the Runable pass-through, and with these two components we are going to pass we are passing this the execution of the tools. First of all, mapping the input to the tool, and then on passing the output of this tool to the chain back, and finally all these intermediary outputs and execution logs back as well to the LLM to build the final answer. And again, remember that in chain we work sequentially, so if something is not sequential, not organized sequentially, it will be difficult, when not impossible, for the chain to execute it, regardless that the chain or the LAN chain understand that it has a tool among the those that are binded to the LLM that it can use to execute that to execute that command or that tool. So we built a function to just map the Runable pass through output to the appropriate tool. We simply create the list of tools. This is exactly the same that we had on the previous experiment. We bind the tools to the LLM. We create a dictionary with just simply the name of the tool and the function itself. As you can see here, is a the structured tool function, and you map it in a dictionary to the name of the function. Then we create with a runable lambda a mapping that in this variable called lustre, and we build the chain using the model with the binded the tools, the function JSON output tool parser, which is going to parse to take the output of every individual state and pass through this to the next tool executed on the sequence on the chain in that case. And then once we have the chain, we can invoke here. It's a simple query. There is no a single input. There is no how to say complication. There is only a possible tool to use. And then on, you see that here directly use a multiply because, well, it's understanding that it map understanding this sentence. It's mapping this sentence means to you need to multiply 23 by 7, and then it's taking the first input and the second input. We do here the same, and here I think I delete the comment. And now I will show you what happened with the chain building that way and why here our life is slightly more complicated than when you create it with an agent. You pass exactly the same, and remember that here to do this calculation, even if you do it how to say in your own with paper and a pen, you will do it in that way. You first of all, we do this calculation, then on this and 12 and 3, then on you will multiply, and then on you will score the result, no? And then, but as the nature of the chain is sequential, what is going to happen is what you see here in the input. It takes, it analyze the text, is analyzing as well the text sequentially, and then they take 7 to the fifth power, and then it the LAN chain is able to map this to the exponentiate tool and execute it. Then on, it sees that you have here multiply, but it doesn't have the second member, so it cannot execute multiply. Then on, it continue. And then on you see that you had sum of 12 and 3, and it's exactly the same what it's doing, adding first 12 and second 3, and then on continue with 10 square the whole result, square the whole result. Why is not executing this? Because was unable to execute multiply. So if I was unable to execute multiply, I also unable to multiply to calculate the square of the whole result. So I tried to build here something, but I was it didn't work. So I let you. I will pass you later on, as I said, the output. Try yourself, and if you get it, please post it, and then we will enjoy as well everybody or somebody that solved the problem with a chain. And well, all of us will learn how to do it. But the way to do it, to solve it, is at the end to create a rephrase or rewrite this input in such way that you execute the instructions or the tools sequentially. So you first of all take the 7 to the fifth power, then on you make the sum. You probably can introduce this in intermediary variables, and then on you all of this you can tell the LLM because the LLM is going to understand it. And then on multiply this as I try to do here, no? I think that it with some a little bit more of rewriting that will be done, no? So what I try to do here is just first I take this and assign to a variable set sum 12 and 3 and assign it to y, multiply set by y and assign the result to x. and then square x. But finally it didn't work as well, but I don't know why. Probably again, probably some misspell in some of the words. And then try yourself, please, and if somebody get it, please post it on the comments of the video. It will be good if somebody can get it. Now we move to the predefined tools, those that you have available on LangChain, on community mostly, where I showed you before. We are going to use Wikipedia, and it's that simple than this. You just import the tool from LangChain tools, from in this case from community, and you create there is always an object for the tool and a wrapper for running the tool. We create the object. Here is the simple one. It just return me the top K result of the query I'm gonna make to Wikipedia. You need to install the Wikipedia library. I think it's having here on the requirements. Let me check. Here, exactly. You need Wikipedia and also LangChain Hub for this exercise. And then on. You just create the object. This is return maximum 2000. You can execute, for example, 4000. And then you create the execution object. And that's it. What is Neo4j? And you have it here. This is connecting with Wikipedia to API and returning you the most appropriate or the most close result to what you input to the tool. Here, exactly the same with I make another using Wikipedia, but well, this is probably it's not the best tool, it's not a news tool, like it could be Google Search or DuckDuckGo. It's just a tool with this. It's more explaining you what is the Prime Minister role rather than telling you who is the Prime Minister of United Kingdom. That is what I wanted to know. But later on I will show you how to do it in any case. Now we are going to use a tool that executes arbitrary code, in this case in a Pandas data frame. For those that don't know what is Pandas, it's a tool for analysis, data analysis and manipulation. It's a well spread using among people who is working in data engineering, in machine learning and data analytics. Is a tool that you need to know, especially if you are working with Python, obviously. But for those that are in this working in this line of business, all of them knows. For those that are not familiar, if you are starting in this line of business, you need to know this tool, because it's broadly used and it's very powerful. You can do many things, and you can read structured and unstructured data, transform all of them in what they know Pandas data frame. And data frame is a structured container where you can apply multiple, well, probably hundreds or different methods and functionalities that you can apply on this data frame. For those that are working with Excel, you will find that this is pretty similar to be working with Excel, but in Python. Here, in fact, we are uploading the Titanic CSV file. For those that knows what is this is coming from the Kaggle, one of the Kaggle challenge, where they create a challenge to work with the, I don't remember wrongly, it was to create the, let me check, Titanic Kaggle challenge. Suppose Titanic tutorial. But take a look and you will. It was a challenge, it's very old already. Yeah. And here. Predict survival of the Titanic, no? Who. According to what we know, they use the data set to predict who was be able to survive or not. Well, take a look, it's very interesting, very old study. It's one of the first challenge that was published in Kaggle. Well, you can download there from there. If not, I will post it as well, the Titanic data set on the repository. Well, we here with Pandas, we just open the file and then we just print the save 887 rows, 8 columns. The columns are with this command, the F columns to list, survives, P class, name. And here we are just simply showing the first rows of the data frame. Here, just keep in mind this, and then now we are going to use this is not necessary. We use the class Python as a ref tool, which is a class on the experimental. Remember, experimental is, as the name said, still not an official part of the core or community library, so it can change without any notice. So be careful if you plan to use this in a production system. So we create an object of the Python as rep tool. We pass as an input the data frame that we open, and we just invoke a Python command in the data frame. Here we are calculating the mean of this column, which is a fare, is the price of the ticket or the billet. I don't know how it was named on that at that time. And then LangChain chain is returning you the value, the execution of that command. I executed the same here directly on the data frame. For those that know how Pandas works, you may understand that it's working perfectly. So you do the same here, tools invoke df columns. You are just returning the columns of the data frame, and you see here that is exactly matched with what we have here. And finally, I will show you Google Search. To use Google Search engine in LangChain, you need first of all, the first thing, you need to have an account in Google Cloud. If you don't have it, you may not be able to use this, but well, you can create one yourself. You just need a credit card. They are going to give you $200, or at least it's what they give me years ago, to just play with all the services available in Google Cloud, machine learning services, data services, a lot of things there. And then you just create the tool. Doesn't mean that you can spend the credit that they give you and later on delete it. It's not a problem. But you need an account in Google Cloud together with a project. You define a project when you set up the cloud. And once you have there, you can go to this link here, to the first one, programmable share engine, and create a programmable share engine. So I think it's here, exactly. I already had one created. You just hit add, you get a name. It doesn't matter because we are not going to use it, at least for LangChain. It doesn't matter. We just need the ID, and here you specify the scope. Do you want images, safe share? And probably you will need to solve the captcha and create it. In that case, you later take this ID, you copy, and this ID is what is connected to this environmental variable. If you don't have the Google key, you are not going to be able to use this search engine, so you will need to create your own one. Then on you create I pass you as well this link to how to create an API for to use the Google APIs. You can follow here that one, Google API client libraries, and how to create. You just follow the tutorial, it's pretty easy to use. And here I pass you as well this Stack Overflow question that explain all the process step by step. So you need to have these two variables on memory in your environment before continue. We just create a search API wrapper, and we import the Google search API wrapper. We create an object. This object is going to check if you have these two variables in memory, and we create the tool with what? With a name, with a description, and with the function to execute, with this search run in this case, which is running a query in Google. And then here I make a question to Google, who is the Prime Minister of the UK, and obviously here is going to return me something more actual. So the best match is that one, which is Rishi Sunak, which is correct. And this kind of tools is broadly used, for example, when you are creating RAC components, is broadly used. And here a couple of links that are interesting to use. This is very interesting, how to introduce human in the loop. So just simply imagine that you are going to execute a command to delete a file or delete a record in the database, or just send an email to somebody else. You just introduce a human approval in the loop. And after this approval is not given, or maybe it's not given, it is not given, it's not doing anything, but if you give it, it's when the chain continues. Very interesting for some stuff that your chain will be able to do with some kind of intelligence. And, in some cases, it probably, depending on the policy or your company, this in many cases will be necessary to implement it. And then on some others, like working in with multiple, how to execute in parallel different tools. This is with agents. And secondly, how to recover from errors. Just imagine that you have a tool that connects to a database, but this database is down, and then you can capture the exception that produced your tool and redirect the query to another database or to another tool that had the same information or similar one. And that's all. I hope you enjoy and you like the content of this video. It's pretty interesting, pretty powerful. This component is something that you need to know for sure, especially working with the QA and conversational chatbots, with something that is interacting with clients, with humans. It's going to be able to do many, many things, and in really, really powerful. You need to know how this works. And again, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy. And as I said, always, if you like it, give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you. See you soon.